মোৰ একেটি সুৰত বাঁহীটি বন্ধা, একেটি মাথোন্মাত, একেটি মাথোন্মাত, ৰাতিয়ে দিনে এটি হুমুনিয়া, একেটি আনন্দতা।
One of the leading figures in the pan-Indian literary scenario during the early 20th century, Laxminath Bezboruah is probably the most influential writers of Assam after Mahapurukh Srimanta Shankardev. Christened as Sahityarathi, charioteer of literature, Bezboruah's literary career spreads over half a century during the last two decades of the 19th and the first three decades of the 20th century. In fact, it was the period of building the foundation of modern Assamese language and literature, and Bezboruah played a leading role in it. He was a prolific writer who earned enviable success at almost all genres of literature and penned Assam's state anthem, O Mur Apunar Desh. Bezboruah's great-grandfather, Kolibor Boruah, a Brahmin from Kannauj in Uttar Pradesh, came to Assam as pilgrimage during the late 17th century. He was a Vedic scholar and an Ayurveda medicine specialist. Ahom King Sorgodeo Joyadhaj Hingha requested him to settle in Assam and offered him huge land, property and money. Boruah complied to King's request and he soon was conferred the title Bezboruah, the chief medical officer of the Ahom royalty. Bezboruah's father, Dinanath Bezboruah, worked under British government as extra assistant commissioner. Once in 1864, while the family was traveling to Borpeta from Nogaon on boat, Laxminath Bezboruah was born. It was the day of the sacred Lakhi Puja, which marked the birth of a genius of modern Indian literature. Since he was born on the day of Lakhmi Purnima, he was named Laxminath. Having completed his matriculation from Hibahagar Government High School in 1886, Bezboruah, like many other academically ambitious students of Assam, went to Kolkata for higher education. He took graduation from Calcutta University and then started studying MA and law under the same university. But a man of diverse interests and independent mindset, Bezboruah could not complete his education. In fact, Bezboruah's life as a creative writer took a distinctive shape in Kolkata during that very period. The city's literary, liberal, and intellectual life gave a tremendous boost to the career of Bezboruah. He initiated the literary crusade by establishing the Ahomiya Bhasha Unnati Hadhini Sabha in 1889 as its founder secretary. In 1890, the legendary Assamese journal Jonaki was launched under the editorship of Chandra Kumar Agarwala. Bezboruah actively participated in this venture. His first satirical pieces appeared in the pages of Jonaki. After that, he himself launched another significant Assamese journal, Bahi. During that very time, Bezboruah joined Kolkata-based Assamese timber merchant Bholanath Boruah's huge business firm, B.N. Boruah and Company, as a working partner. Bezboruah had already came in contact with the famous Tagore family of Zorahaku in Kolkata, which had resulted in his marriage with Pragya Hundari Devi the daughter of Hemendranath Tagore, which was the elder brother of Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore. Bholanath Boruah knew well as to how much vibrant the connection Laxminath had with Kolkata's social circle, with the railway officers and with the trading community. He could rightly visualize how well this connection would help their business enterprise. Visionary, Bholanath made Laxminath the public face of their enterprise, and Bezboruah left no stone unturned to take the timber business enterprise to a great height. But fortified with lots of business experience, and after a conflict with Bholanath, Bezboruah started his own business. But the economic depression in 1914, owing to the World War I, hit hard Bezboruah's business, and gradually the situation became so grave that in 1916 he had to join a job in the British timber business house Bard & Company. Bezboruah worked in the company's Kolkata office till 1917. In September 1917, he was transferred to Sambalpur in Odisha. In those days, Sambalpur was a sleepy township surrounded by deep and dense forests and jungles. The township was a hub of timber business because of the forest resources, mainly the huge quantity of trees. Although today's increasing population and hecticity in the township hardly carry the impression of Sambalpur during a century back. Even the Shamaleshwari temple, the epicenter of religious activities for Hindu residents of the township since ages, has attained a new look. But one thing that has remained the same as it was a century ago, and that is the river, the mighty Mahanadi, which flows quietly by the township of Sambalpur. Sahityarathi Laxminath Bezboruah, who was born on the bed of the mighty river Brahmaputra and had spent his childhood in Hibahagar, situated in the bank of the river Dhanhiri, must have found an eternal solace in the banks of river Mahanadi when he had landed up in Sambalpur to earn his livelihood. It was in the bank of Mahanadi in Sambalpur township where Bezboruah began the second glorious chapter of his professional and creative life. He spent 2 decades in Sambalpur, and during his stay here, he was inspired by the beauty and magnitude of the river Mahanadi, the countryside and the lifestyle of the people, about which he later mentioned in his autobiography with a rare sensibility. Bezboruah's 20-year-long, tremendously affectionate bond with Sambalpur began in this house of J.N. Sen, where he had first checked in on his arrival at Sambalpur. Later on, he shifted to another rented house in Kunjalpara locality of Sambalpur, which was then called Mission House. The house is now the office of the Sambalpur District Cooperative Central Bank Limited.
I am the grandson of Dr. Sanatan Behera, and my grandfather told me that he was friendly to Mr. Laxminath Bezboruah. And Laxminath Bezboruah, when he came to Sambalpur, he was staying in Kunjalpada Mission House, where actually we stayed for a very long time. And at that time I was not born, but I heard from my grandfather that he was staying there. Then he shifted to Dr. Pujari's house, Jonathan Pujari's house, and from there he constructed a house and stayed there for some time. And I am very proud that 150th year of his Path anniversary is going to be celebrated. And I, on behalf of the people of Sambalpur and my friends, etc., and family, I wish that this function may be a very great success.
During the early 20s, Bezboruah then shifted to this 3-storied house in the nearby locality. That house belonged to Dr. Janardhan Pujari, a renowned person in the elite and cultured circle of Sambalpur.
I have heard from my family members that Mr. Bezboruah was residing in our Jharapada house during 1920. Then we could know his great personality. But of late, we could know he is a great man, he is a great personality, and we are proud of that, that such a personality was residing in our own house. I am proud of that, and more probably our India is proud of that, our Sambalpur is proud of that.
Sambalpur township was surrounded by a series of deep, dense reserve forests, and the closer ones were Jamra, Meghpal, Pramanpur, Samundra and Durgapali. Most of these forest areas are no more. Moreover, construction of new developmental projects too have jeopardized the existence of forest covers. In Pramanpur and Durgapali Reserve Forest, an aluminium factory, namely Hindalco, has been set up. Bezboruah's duty and responsibility in Sambalpur was to supervise the collection of timber logs from inside the forest and then bring these to the shape of wooden sleeper for construction of railway track. After that, the materials were to be supplied to the various railway track construction sites under Bengal-Nagpur Railway. The job was quite a hard one and was of totally contrary nature for a creative writer like Bezboruah. But he accepted it as a big challenge and performed his duty perfectly well. This is the house inside the Meghpal forest, which Bezboruah used as his office and stayed occasionally when he had to spend the night in the forest. This is the Hirakund Hydel project, which was constructed by destroying Jamra Reserve Forest during late Chief Minister Biju Patnaik's regime. In this way, Sahityarathi Bezboruah passed his days in Sambalpur while working hard in the forest and then getting involved in the socio-cultural and administrative scenario of Sambalpur. Simultaneously, he continued his relentless literary pursuits. This is Mahanadi Club, which was earlier called European Club. Bezboruah was an elite member of this club. He was also the secretary of the Bengali Club. He was the president of the managing committee of Crawford's Girls High School. This is the view of Victoria Hall, in which Bezboruah took initiative in organizing many cultural and literary programs. He even used to play roles in the stage dramas written by Tagore and himself as well. The famous and historic Sambalpur Municipality Office building was constructed under the supervision and initiative of Bezboruah in 1927. Bezboruah was nominated by the government as a councillor of Sambalpur Municipality for a period of 10 years. This is the inside view of the Municipality Council Hall. Bezboruah's portrait is still being hung in the wall of this hall with utter regard and affection, alongside the portrait of the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi.
Laxminath Bezboruah, who hails from Assam, was municipal councillor in Sambalpur Municipality. In long back, his contribution was very much memorable in Sambalpur town as well as nearby areas of this Sambalpur municipality. We are very much proud of for his contribution to this municipality. His contribution has already taken this municipality to a new era. We remember his name and we have decided to celebrate his 150th birth centenary in Sambalpur in and around municipality. As a tribute to the personality of late Laxminath Bezboruah, we have installed his photograph in our council hall in the year 1968 during the celebration of his birth centenary.
Sahityarathi Laxminath Bezboruah, a lot of contribution he had for our area, specifically Sambalpur, we observed at that time 100th anniversary. And we love him for that reason. We observed recent past, last December only, 150th birth anniversary of Laxminath Bezboruah.
When I came to know who Bezboruah is, then my interest grew up more and more. And when I found that he is such a towering personality, then I decided to write a book on him so that people of Sambalpur will know him. Today, I am very satisfied that people of Sambalpur, they know who Bezboruah is. Because of Bezboruah, we have got the privilege. Sambalpur has become a well-known name in the household of Assam. It's a great pride for us. Bezboruah stayed here and participated in every activities, many activities. He was the councillor for 10 years in the municipality and did a good work in construction of the building. He also got involved in many ways in the social and cultural life of Sambalpur. As we see today, people who are staying away from his homeland, he is staying away from his own language, culture, everything. But Bezboruah, who remained far from his homeland for a pretty long time, how he managed to write such good essays, good short stories, good poems, it is nothing but wonder.
I have a kind of nostalgic attachment with the very name Laxminath Bezboruah. We were young, we were in the college, that was sometime in 68. By then his birth centenary had been celebrated elsewhere in 64. And literatures from Assam came to Sambalpur. We were college students, our principal, our teachers of literature, they said that they have come to commemorate the 100th year of arrival of a great literary genius of India, not only of Assam. And that was the time when I got attracted towards Bezboruah. And in translation, I started reading him. I knew Bengali script, but although there is similarity between Bengali and Assamese script, Assamese language I was little apprehensive of understanding. But ultimately, when I got posted in Northeast, stayed in Guwahati, I found that Sambalpuri language and Ohmya are very close to each other. And I started reading some short stories of Laxminath, the Sahityarathi, and I was impressed. At that time, I found that perhaps he is writing about me, my land, my river, my mountain, my jungle, my streets, my characters. So a kind of rapport was established between the author, who was no more, and me, a young reader. He was a creative writer, no doubt, but basically he was a human being, a socialite. And mark his linkage with the literary milieu of that time, the environment of that time. He was closely related because of marriage and because of other reasons to the Tagore family. Likewise, when he came here to Sambalpur, he got associated with the Mishra family, the Sen family, the Pujari family, the Supakar family. They were also highly educated and they were a part of the Oriya Renaissance and the Assam Renaissance. He perhaps got a very fertile ground in Sambalpur to foster his own talent, a genius of writing prose. He wrote the best of his prose in Sambalpur, but we didn't know much about him. And the worst part of it is, we Indians are very bad historians. We don't know how to preserve our heritage. Even we do not know how to preserve our ruins, the broken temples, the dilapidated houses, the palaces, the museums, the artifacts. One such landmark is the house that Mr. Bezboruah built himself. He didn't purchase it, he constructed himself with all sweat and labor. And the house is in a very dilapidated state. You will feel sad about it. Tears will roll down your eyes. That had 12 rooms, a large enough bungalow for a man who was not a government servant at that point of time. Maybe it was larger, it was not a multi-storied building, it was a single-storied building, but as sprawling as that of the official bungalow of the superintendent of police or even the deputy commissioner at that time.
With his well-read, intellectual, mental makeup and polite but straightforward nature, Bezboruah had easily formed an intimate rapport with the elite section of Sambalpur. Having stayed in a rented house for some years, Bezboruah finally bought a big 2.4-acre plot of land and constructed his house there. This is a single-storied 12-room house he had constructed. Political agent J.N. Sen's residence and the T District Labour Association office are to its left. Residence of the Superintendent of Police is to its right. Mahanadi Club is in the front and the river, the mighty Mahanadi, flows by its rear side. Bezboruah himself wrote the Bird Company on being satisfied with his job performance, increased his salary to Rs. 300 a month, which was a big fortune during those days. Moreover, he was given the perks of a chauffeur-driven car and fuel and other facilities. Bezboruah constructed the house in such a design that the company's British officials used to stay in this house whenever they visited Sambalpur. Moreover, one would now find it hard to believe that in this presently dilapidated house, big dinner and luncheon parties involving the entire elite section of Sambalpur were held. Nobel laureate Tagore had even spent some days in this house. This is a separate portion of the house which was called Sadhana Griha, Bezboruah's office and study area. The present condition of this heritage house is the most painful scene for any educated, cultured person having respect and adoration for a legendary writer who is considered the father of modern Assamese literature. His Excellency, Honorable Governor of Assam, Janaki Ballabh Patnaik, has shown keen initiative for preservation of this house as a heritage building. He has visited this house and its surroundings for several times himself. A team of Ahom Sahitya Sabha, led by then President Padma Shri Rongbong Terang, also visited this house on the 3rd of April 2012. After physical inspection of the house, Ahom Sahitya Sabha members appealed to the government of Assam to take up immediate measures for proper preservation of this heritage building. According to official records, Bezboruah had willed this house in the name of his eldest daughter, Aruna Mukherjee, on the 25th of November 1936. He had returned to Assam in 1937 and had breathed his last in 1938. Aruna Mukherjee had sold the house to someone called Onkarmal Poddar, who even could not take the possession of the house because of some legal disputes. Thus, the matter was pushed to the court of law, and since then it has remained as sub judice. There are some working class people residing in and around the house. Some of them are buffalo rearers and they keep their buffaloes within the campus of the house. They introduce themselves as the tenants of Onkarmal Poddar, and in this way they are occupying the areas in and around the house and contributing towards its unabated destruction. Interestingly, till a few years back, the Orissa government had used the Sadhana Griha as the office of Inspector of Revenue. But due to the increasing dilapidation of the house, the Orissa government shifted the office to some other place. But time is running out fast, and soon the day will come when no one will see the present ruins of this house anymore.
We are trying very much to hold his old house, which is in ruin now. We want that there should be a memorial in the name of Bezboruah in that area where he lived for such a long time.
That area is disputed. The rights on the property is being disputed. I will say with firmness that the house that Mr. Bezboruah lived in for decades in Sambalpur is not anybody's personal property. It is national heritage. It should be treated as such, as national heritage. I will give you an example. The house of Ghalib, the great Urdu poet of the mid 19th century, 1840s, 50s, 60s in Delhi, his houses, wherever he used to stay, have been declared as national property. So why not the government of Assam, Orissa and government of India, because of cultural reasons, to preserve heritage, would not take over that? If that is disputed because of revenue laws or because of disputes about ownership, who purchased it, how it was purchased, from whom it was purchased, where are the documents, I will not go into that. That a great soul, an author of repute, an author who was a part of the Renaissance period of the early 19th and late, early 20th and late 19th century, was living, working and wanted to come back before he died, but he could not. That should be taken over by the government, if necessary, by an act, an ordinance or by paying compensation. So that we the Indians, not only the Ahom people, the Ahomiyas or the Oriyas or the Sambalpuriyas, will be proud of what Bezboruah was. And I can lastly say only that when we remember him after 150 years of his birth and about more than 70, 80 years of his death, our greatest homage to him, our pranam to him will be to revive his heritage.
The Assam government is very keen to first to acquire the property. In fact, we, the Honorable Chief Minister of Assam and also His Excellency the Governor of Assam, has taken steps in this regard. And the Honorable Chief Minister of Assam has requested the Chief Minister of Odisha to acquire the property for us. And once it is acquired, we will take steps to restore the property, because there are certain photographs and documentation which has already been done in the Cultural Affairs Department, and we hope that we will be able to restore it once the property comes to our hand. But the fact remains that the property is under litigation, and I think possibly that has been the reason why the government of Orissa has not yet been able to acquire the property, or at least take steps to initiate the land acquisition or the acquisition of that property. For once we receive the requisition from the Orissa government as to the amount of money that will be required for the acquiring of the property, we will definitely place it with the Orissa government and then take over the property.
I am, after handing over the land and the residential quarters where Laxminath Bezboruah lived to the Assam government, it would be acquired by Orissa government and given to the Assam government. The land was sold, the residential land was sold by Laxminath Bezboruah's daughter after the passing of Laxminath Bezboruah. It was After that, the government acquired it. Then the government gave it in lease to a Marwadi family, Sambalpur town, and that Marwadi family is in possession of it. Now, we have persuaded the present heir of the lessee that this land, this residence should be sold to Odisha government or to be acquired by Odisha government, so that the Odisha government, the Assam government would get this land through the Odisha government as a memorial for Laxminath Bezboruah on his centenary.
The last big blow to the existence of the minimum remains of Bezboruah's house in Sambalpur and the plan for its preservation by the government of Assam came up on 29th of January 2014 when Orissa Chief Minister laid the foundation stone of a new bridge over River Mahanadi. If it is materialized this way, then the bridge will be constructed touching the boundary of the house, and then the entire house will be dismantled and the complete plot will be taken over for bridge construction purpose.
We will immediately take up with the government of Orissa that, leaving aside the outcome of the litigation or the acquiring, that the property should be maintained as it is, at least, and that part should not be made a part of the master plan leading to the bridge. At least the house part of it, where the Sahityarathi did his work, we definitely have an interest in preserving it as it is.
Well, after this handing over this land and residential building to government of Assam, this thing would be settled out. There is no problem. Could be settled amicably between the two governments. Now, at last, I think the time has come when the Advocate General would move a petition for necessary vacation of that land by the lessee, and then it would be acquired or bought by the government of Odisha to be handed over to the government of Assam. I am after that.
It is high time now to pursue the matter as top priority. Sahityarathi Laxminath Bezboruah struggled throughout his life for a literary and cultural regeneration in Assam. He enriched the Assamese language by exploring its resources in his writings. He gave the Assamese language the power to express a wide range of thoughts, feelings, and emotions. He taught Assamese people to be proud of our cultural heritage. In his writings, he proved how racy, direct, and precise the speech and the idioms of the common people might be. It is amazing how a businessman having a very tight schedule and living most of the time out of Assam could do so much for Assamese literature and culture. He led the movement of Assamese literature during a crucial period. And the major portion of this creative pursuits and organizing efforts were carried out from this very house, which he himself had constructed and lived for decades. It is unquestionably a moral responsibility of the government and the people of Assam and India to preserve the ruins of this house and create a heritage site in this plot of land with a new and innovative design, so that the nation can be proud of paying a befitting tribute in the truest sense to one of the most prolific writers of pan-Indian literary scenario, and above all, a great humanist.